Welcome to the spoken tutorial on underwater animation using Synfig. In this tutorial, we will familiarize ourselves with animating images in Synfig. We will learn to import PNG and SVG, animate the images by using distortion, add noise gradient, and use random option for random animation. Using the above, we will learn to create an underwater animation. To record this tutorial, I am using Ubuntu Linux 14.04 OS and Synfig Studio version 1.0.2. We are in the Synfig interface. I have saved my Synfig file as underwater animation. Please do so likewise. Now, let us start creating our underwater animation. For underwater animation, we will need a background, some bubbles, and some water plants. We also need some creatures like fish, frog, crab, etc. To create this animation, I am going to use the images that I created earlier. For practice, learners can use the images provided in the code files link of this tutorial. Background, octopus, water plant, bubble, fish as PNG images, frog and crab as SVG images. Let us start to import the PNG images for our underwater animation one by one. For that, go to File and click on Import. Click on Desktop and double click on Underwater Animation and select Background PNG. Then click on Import. We get the image on the canvas. In the same way, import water plant, fish 1, fish 2, octopus, frog, crab, bubble as demonstrated. You should see a list like this in layers panel. To create separate group of each graphic like plant, fish 1, etc. Select imported layers respectively. Then right click on layer. Select group layer. Let us now rename these group layers as demonstrated. Come back to the canvas. Scale all the images and arrange the underwater scene as shown here. Sometimes, while importing SVG file, it may show errors in Synfig. As you can see here, frog eyes are missing, so I will draw it again. We will now go to the time track panel. Place the time cursor on start frame. Click on turn on animate editing mode icon. Go to layers panel. Click on triangle to expand fish 1 group layer. Right click on the fish 1 layer PNG. Go to new layer. Then select distortion and click on twirl. Now we will animate the tail part of the fish. Back to the canvas. Place the twirl effect as demonstrated. Adjust the twirl. Now, move the cursor to the 10th frame. Go back to the canvas. Twirl effect can be done by moving the twirl handles, that is the blue dot as demonstrated. We see the rotation value as -50.60 degree. Move the cursor to the 18th and 24th frames one by one and repeat the same steps. Change the amount of rotations as 32 degrees and -5 degrees respectively. Likewise, I will give twirl effect twice for animating the upper and lower fins of the fish. For repetitive animation till the end, we need to give a time loop. For that, right click on the topmost layer of the fish group layer. Now, go to new layer, then other and click on time loop. Now, go to layers panel and select fish layer. Go to the time track panel and place the cursor on the 0th frame. Move the fish as demonstrated. Go to the time track panel and place the cursor on the 100th frame. move the fish as demonstrated. Similarly, we will animate fish too. Let us save our file before proceeding further. Now, let us animate the crab claws. Go to Layers panel. Click on Triangle to expand crab group layer. Here, I need to do separate groups for different parts of the crab. Then, select the first part of claw 1 and right click on it. Go to New Layer and then Transform and click on Rotate. Adjust the rotate handle as demonstrated. Go to the Time Track panel and place the cursor on the 10th frame. Now, go to the Parameters panel and change the rotate amount to 18 degrees. Again, go to the Layers panel. Select the second part of claw 1 and right click on it. Go to New Layer, then Transform and click on Rotate. Adjust the rotate handle as demonstrated. Go to Time Track panel and place the cursor on the 10th frame. Go to Parameters panel and change the rotate amount to minus 7 degrees. Likewise, animate claw 2. Next, we will animate the eyes of the crab. Go to Layers panel and open the eye group layer. Select the black parts of both the eyeballs using Ctrl key. Go to Time Track panel and place the cursor on the 9th frame. Now, go to the canvas and move the black parts of both the eyeballs as demonstrated. Again, go to the Time Track panel and place the cursor on the 18th frame. Now, go to the canvas and move the black parts of both the eyeballs as demonstrated. For repetitive animation, till the end, apply the time loop. Once again, let us save our file before proceeding further. Next, we will animate the mouth and tongue of the frog. To do that, first go to Layers panel and open the frog group layer. Select the layers of mouth and tongue and group them together. Let us name this group as mouth and tongue. Go to Layers panel and select the mouth of the frog. Then go to the Time Track panel, place the cursor on the 23rd frame. Move the nodes of the layer as demonstrated. Go to Layers panel and this time select the tongue of the frog. Now go to the Time Track panel and place the cursor on the 23rd frame. Go to Parameters panel and open the vertices group by clicking on triangle icon of vertices group. Select the number of vertex 1 and right click on it. Click on Mark active point as off option. Do likewise for vertex number 2 to 12 on the same keyframe. Go to Layers panel and right click on Water Plant PNG layer. Go to New Layer, then to Distortion and click on Twirl. Go to Time Track panel and place the cursor on the 13th frame. Go to Parameters panel, change the rotation value of Twirl to 23 degrees. Now, go to 25th frame. Here, change the rotation value of Twirl to minus 9 degrees. Save the file once again. Next, we will animate the octopus. Select Octopus group layer, go to Canvas and move the octopus on keyframes 0, 75, 135 and 185 as demonstrated. Go to Layers panel and select Octopus PNG layer. Right click on that layer. Now go to New Layer, then Distortion and click on Stretch. go to time track panel and place the cursor on 1/30th frame. Come back to the canvas. Move the orange dot to get stretch effect on the octopus image as demonstrated here. Similarly, place the cursor on 145, 150, 160, 168, 172 and move the orange dot of stretch as demonstrated. Next, select the bubble layer. Right click on it and go to new layer and then transform. Click on translate. Go to parameters panel and right click on origin. Then go to convert and click on random. Go to layers panel, select the bubble layer and click on duplicate layer icon. Repeat 3 more times and arrange the bubbles as shown here. Go to layers panel, select the topmost layer, right click on it and go to new layer, then gradient. Click on noise gradient. Go to parameters panel, change the amount to 0.5. Change the blend method to multiply and change the size to 60 to 300 pixels as demonstrated. Go to time track panel and place the cursor on 200th frame. Go to parameters panel, increase the value of random noise seeds. Lastly, save the file. Go to file and click on render. Go to render setting window. Click on choose. Change the extension to AVI. Go to target drop down menu and select FFmpeg. Click on end time and change it to 200. And click on render. To see the animation, go to desktop, select underwateranimation.avi, double click on it. With this, we have come to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned about underwater animation in Synfig. We also learned to import PNG and SVG, animate with distortion option like twirl, stretch, add noise gradient, use random option for random animation. Here is an assignment for you. Locate the simple design shape file which is provided in the code files link. Import this file. Animate by using twirl effect. Your completed assignment should look like this. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please watch it. We conduct workshops using spoken tutorial and give certificates. Please contact us. Please post your time queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by NMEICT MHRD Government of India. This is Sheetal along with the Spoken Tutorial Animation team from IIT Bombay signing off. Thanks for joining.